We'd like to thank all the friends and loved ones gathered here today to celebrate the union of Michael and Nikki. This joyous occasion marks the beginning of a special chapter in their lives. Let us celebrate the happiness Michael and Nikki bring to each other. With a strong foundation of love, trust, mutual respect, they will now embark upon a lifelong journey together. Marriage is a sacred human tradition. As we gather here before God, let us recognize the significance of the vows that will be spoken today. Not only do they mark a lifelong commitment, but they represent a tradition which dates back thousands of years. There truly is nothing so powerful as love. As the Bible reminds us in Song of Solomon, many waters cannot quench love. Rivers cannot wash it away. If one were to give all the wealth of his house for love, it would be utterly sworn. When we marry, we make a decision to share all aspects of ourselves with another. Today, Michael and Nikki have chosen to take this step. Under the eyes of God, we pause for a moment to acknowledge the gravity of the commitment Michael and Nikki are about to enter into. As the Bible reminds us in Ecclesiastes, with loving companionship, you may overcome any obstacle. Two are better than one, because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. But pity anyone who falls and has no one to help them up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? While a serious commitment, this ceremony obviously brings us great joy as well. The couple that stands before us clearly shares a special bond, and I'd like to offer them a chance to express their love for each other. To that end, I will now invite the bride and groom to share their vows. Michael, repeat after me. Nikki, today we begin a shared life together.
Nikki, we begin a shared life together.
One I cannot wait to start. No matter what the future may bring. I make these solemn promises. I vow to love you endlessly. To care for you selflessly.
And to cherish you daily.
Michael.
One that I cannot wait to start.
No matter what the future may bring, I make these solemn promises. I vow to love you endlessly.
To care for you selflessly.
And to cherish you daily. And now we'll proceed. Michael and Nikki, you're joining hands. Michael, in front of all those gathered today, do you take Nikki to be your wife, to stay by her through sickness and health, through failure and success, through times of sorrow and times of joy, so long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
Nikki, in front of all these gathered today, take Michael to be your husband, to stay by him through sickness and health, through failure and success, through times of sorrow and times of joy, so long as you both shall live. Excellent choice. Now it is time to exchange rings. Wedding rings serve as a physical representation of your bond, a constant reminder of the commitment you're undertaking. But they serve a symbolic purpose as well. As you prepare to place a ring on Nikki's finger, take a moment to appreciate its circular shape. Just as circular has no end, so too will your union be everlasting. Michael, repeat after me.
I, Michael, give you Nikki.
This ring is a sign of endless love for you.
This ring is a sign of endless love for you.
May it ever serve to remind us of the bond we share.
May it ever serve us. What?
Serve.
Is a reminder of the bond we share. Sir.
I, Nikki, give you Michael. This ring is a sign of endless love for you. May it ever serve to remind us of the bond we share. By the power vested in me, by the Universal Life Church, the state of Texas, I pronounce you Michael and Nikki as husband and wife. May God bless you.
I can. How long will I need you? As long as the seasons need to follow their plan. How long will I be with you? As long as the sea is bound to wash from the sun. So it goes. Charlie to the sea. Darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. You.